Let's keep going. And let's look at the factor affect the blood pressure. You can affect the blood pressure by controlling the blood volume. Because the cardiovascular system is a closed system. So you put more blood in, while you increase the blood pressure. And the medicine to work on this part. So all this, you have the medicine, you can affect it. Diuretic medicine. Diuretic is make you pee more. And work on the kidney. So why? Because, well, when you pee more, you decrease the blood volume and the blood pressure decrease. So they also explained why people have hypertension should not eat too salty food, because when you take sodium, water follow. You learn that in the unit one, osmolarity. So you eat too much sodium, you keep water, it's a problem to treat hypertension. So that's this part. The pump, the cardio output, right? So you're very familiar with this because we spent so much time talking about this. You can affect the heart rate, you can affect the stroke volume, and these are all beta 1 receptor regulated. So beta blocker, that's a medicine, directly work on this part. It can work on pacemaker cell, it can work on the contractile cell, because both pacemaker cell and contractile cells, they are innervated by the sympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic only innervate pacemaker cell. So beta blocker work on this part. And you can affect the blood pressure by resistance. So we talk about the alpha receptor. Alpha receptor work on the arterial cause vessel constriction. And that's the most efficient way for your body to quickly increase your blood pressure to deal with emergency situation. And vasodilator work on this part. Viagra is not a new medicine. Viagra is the medicine designed to treat hypertension. It's especially pulmonary hypertension. And that medicine works on this part. It can cause the vasodilation. And people find Viagra's function by accident because it dilates the blood vessel. So it can make the blood go to the very important area to cure the erection problem. So people find it by accident, and the Pfizer, pharmaceutical company Pfizer, they make so much money by making Viagra. And everyone knows Viagra's function is actually due to its side effect. It's due to its side effect, vasodilation. And its main function, treat hypertension, work on the dilating blood vessel. And not too many people know its effect. So doctors still prescribe Viagra to some patient to treat the hypertension. And vet, what I heard is vets also prescribe Viagra to big dog to treat the hypertension. And because of this, when you dilate the blood vessel, you decrease the resistance and you lower the blood pressure. And also you can change the blood pressure by regulate the distribution of the blood from the veins, send more back to the heart. And that's when you are exercising, you use the respiratory pump and skeletal pump to send more blood, because it's a closed circle, so blood have to stay somewhere, and most blood stay in the vein. You squeeze more blood back, you can increase the blood pressure. So these are the four factors. They all affect the blood pressure, but they all work on the different part. And in your blood vessel is most of your body part. When we talk about the autonomic nervous system, they are dual innervated. They are innervated by sympathetic and parasympathetic, not the blood vessel. The blood vessel, you have the sympathetic system only. And you only use sympathetic nervous system, how you are able to do both, dilate, constrict, and the key is they constrict the blood vessel a little bit. So they have to constantly release neurotransmitter to constrict the blood vessel a little bit. It's like when you're driving on highway, so you constantly press your accelerator, you keep your speed constant. And you can increase the speed by pressing more, and you can decrease the speed by pressing less. And that's how your sympathetic system, how your sympathetic nervous system are able to regulate your blood vessel diameter by using sympathetic only. So only through the alpha, through use the norepinephrine. So they can release more they can release less, so cause vasoconstriction, vasodilation, so sympathetic only. That's the blood vessel. And they are not just increased the globally increase the resistance, they can change the blood flow. Because when your blood flow out from your aorta, from your left ventricle to the aorta, so the cardio output is about 4 liters per minute. And yes, you can constrict all of them and increase the blood pressure. Also, you can direct some blood go to some important body part. Like when you are fighting the bear, your sympathetic system is super activated. And when you're fighting bear, you don't want too much blood to go to your digestive system. Because if you don't focus on, if you don't win the fight, well, you don't have to worry about the food in the future. You become the food of the bear. So it's going to constrict the blood flow to the digestive, going to send more blood to your brain, to your skeletal muscle, to all the body parts can help you to survive, to win this fight. And they can do this locally. They can constrict those arterial to send the blood to the digestive system. And in the cardiovascular system, because it's closed circle, so the blood have to go somewhere. And when you constrict this one, the blood vessel B, the blood automatically increase their flood to A to C to D. So that's how your body locally regulate the flow from one system to the other system. And this happens when your sympathetic system is activated. And also in the winter, some people in the winter, they feel like, oh, their hands, their leg are cold because of this. It's more important to send more blood to your brain, to your important inner organ to maintain their function, and let your finger, let your leg go. You can still survive with your brain and without your finger. So in the winter, they try to conserve heat by doing this. And this is the local control. You are able to send blood, more blood to one body part than the other. And eventually, all the blood flow, remember I tell you, even though the right pump, the left pump, the right pump is pressure is lower compared with the left pump, and the volume sent out is the same because it's a closed circle. So from your left ventricle, the cardio output about 5 liters per minute, this blood is going to go to, well, your brain. See, your brain is 15%. It can go to 20 or even 25%. When you're taking the test, it can go to 25%. You scratch your head, it's all your fault, Professor Chen. Oh, that's when you go to 25%. And small percentage go to your heart, and go to liver, go to inner organ, kidney. We will talk about this. About 20%, very consistent. This is very consistent. You won't increase, decrease based on your body situation. You actually have a negative feedback, tubular or medullary feedback. We will talk about this in the last unit to maintain your blood flow to the kidney, because this is the filter, so you want the flow to be very consistent no matter how your blood pressure change. So this filter can last forever. This one is very consistent. And the muscle, the others, all of them go back still 100%. This is why the output, the input, they remain the same. So the cardio output from the left, from the right ventricle are the same. And locally, they can use this kind of regulation. Say you start to exercise, and your tissue, your muscle produce more waste particle when you increase the tissue metabolism. And these metabolized molecules, a lot of them are a big portion of them are vasodilator. And this makes biological sense because, well, when you exercise, say you go to the gym, you exercise your biceps branchii, and you did not exercise your abdominal rectus, your six packs. So when you are focusing works on your arm, you want more blood vessel to go to your arm to remove those waste particles. And when you exercise your arm muscle, they're going to produce a vasodilator. So they close the arterial. You found this arterial because these are the small muscles. And when these dilate, more blood automatically go to the biceps branchii. So less blood go to your six packs because of the resistance. So that's how the local control for your body able to direct the blood flow to one body part. Then the next second, it will go to the next body part. So the next minute, when you go to exercise your rectus abdominis, and more blood is going to go to your rectus abdominis. So this is the local control. And these slides tell you your blood flow. So we spend a lot of time talking about the blood flow. Blood flow depends on your pressure gradient divided by your resistance. And the pressure gradient can be affected by mean arterial pressure minus the lowest pressure in the right atrium, right? And the right atrium is zero. Unless you have congenital disease, this is zero. So basically, the pressure gradient part, we only worry about the mean arterial pressure. And how to affect the mean arterial pressure? Well, last time, and this time, we spent so much time talking about this, the blood pressure. You can affect the blood volume. You can increase the blood volume, increase the blood pressure, or decrease the blood volume. Or you can use the venous return. You can send more blood from the vein back. That's this. And you can affect the flow. The flow part is cardio output. And cardio output, now you are very familiar with it. You can affect the heart rate. You can affect the stroke volume. Both of them will affect the cardio output. And heart rate, sympathetic. I'll tell you the answer. Modulation is the sympathetic and parasympathetic. So both of them can regulate the heart rate. Stroke volume, that's the contractile muscle. And based on the Starling's law, your heart muscle love to work. So when you send more blood to the ventricle, you're going to send more out, right? Modulation, what's this one? Sympathetic only. Contractile muscle, sympathetic only. And let's look at the resistance. Resistance depends on the radius, viscosity, length. So most of us, our total blood vessel length is the same. Viscosity, well, unless you don't stop drinking water, your viscosity will remain pretty much the same. The only one change is the radius. So we can change the radius. We can have the global control, reflex control through what the receptor. Sympathetic and is alpha, it's alpha 1, this one receptor. And local control, I use the example when you go to the gym, you exercise. You exercise your arm, your biceps, bronchii, and it's the metabolized molecules that can cause the vasodilation, so that's the local control. So all of this can affect the blood flow. Okay, let's take a short break.